Hello, baby.
This is Hannah Gan, my granddaughter. This for her and her peers and all the little children of the world, that is the reason I'm here. Because what we want is for them to have the freedom to live their lives the way they want to live it, the freedom to choose, and the freedom to be who they are. Thank you, Bungie. Yes, thank you. How are you? So soft, you know. Come on, we're women. It's International Women's Day. People have been asking me why I'm casting bellies. Can anyone tell me why? Isn't it obvious? It's the fire in the belly that brings us here today. It's the fire in our belly that makes changes. It's the fire in our belly that gives us choices. What makes me angry? What makes me angry is when we forget how to be angry. You see, angry has been given a bad outing. Angry is road rage. It's when you chase the car that overtook you on the expressway, corner it on the road shoulder, and go at it with the club you keep under your front seat just for this kind of exigency. Angry is mob behavior. It's unreasoned. It's deflected frustration. Like when dogs turn on each other because the object of their frustration is on the other side of the gate, beyond their reach. It's the husband who turns on his wife, children, dogs, cats, at the smallest provocation. It's the wife who wakes up at 3 a.m. in the morning to hurl insults and worse at the domestic help, the other woman in the house. It's the youth who turns on the elderly and the vulnerable. It's the nerd who films up your skirts in the escalators. It's the army sergeant turned disciplinary master who barks spit down at the quivering school child. This angry is dehumanizing. What makes me angry is when I realize how we've allowed ourselves to be duped into complicity, lulled by material, cowed by pressures to keep the peace, keep the order, the decorum, the form, to surrender our better judgment, our agency, to a higher authority, a silver-tongued authority whose rationalizations diminish us, the people, every day. Through its mouthpiece, the Straits Times. Whose will diminishes our humanity, our intelligence, our dignity, till we turn on one another, man, woman, child, like dogs turn on one another when the cause of their frustration is out of reach. But there is another kind of angry, a more potent, constructive angry, born of compassion and empathy and courage and hope, forged and burnished by the fire in the belly of the best of us. This kind of angry brought women like you and I and many others out of the woodwork into the public eye. Historically, this kind of angry has brought women out to challenge the big guns and corporations for fair wages. This kind of angry has brought women out to challenge, has brought women out to challenge for equal pay and equal work. This kind of angry has mobilized Singapore women to work the streets, to spread the knowledge of family planning, to mobilize against the practice of polygamy, and alleviate the toll on women and children and society at large. This kind of angry has propelled women to take the stand and speak, as we are still doing today, against social, economic, and political injustices. For this fire in the belly, we know very well, we have been called many names. Feisty battle axes and raving lesbians, not the least of them. We embrace these names in the name of the change we wrought and will continue to bring. This is the 103rd International Women's Day, which began in 1848, following on the Seneca Fall Convention, the first ever women's rights convention that started it all. In 1911, the US, more than 1 million, in the US, more than 1 million women and men attended International Women's Day rallies campaigning for women's rights to vote, to work, to be trained, to hold public office, and to end discrimination. On 8 March 1956, near a home in Singapore, over 2,000 people, we have about what? Do we have 200 here? Over 2,000 people, mostly though, trade unionists and Chinese school students, celebrated International Women's Day at four rallies simultaneously at the Badminton Hall, Happy World Stadium, the Civilian Association, and Shenton Way. The rallies passed three resolutions: abolish polygamy, win equal pay for equal work, and to mark International Women's Day as a public holiday. We stand here today indebted to the women, and probably more than a few good men, who have used their anger to make good the imbalances in our world and open up new paths for us. For every joy we experience today as women, we owe to women who have been unafraid to be called names. Thank you all for being here and for contributing your belly full today. May I ask you now to join us in igniting the flame for our past, our present, and our future together, and for the families around the world that are coping with the trials today. Thank you.